Beverly from the Midland Public Library, Program Assistant, and today on our Ways to Wellness, we are going to discuss problem solving. How to solve life's problems. You don't know how to solve life's problem. Life, of course, is full of problems. In fact, it's so full of problems that at times it seems as though solving one problem will create another problem. But having problems is a necessary part of life. And living life in the optimal ways require understanding how to solve problems. In fact, it could be said that those who successfully work through their problems have a happier, more fulfilling, and rewarding life. Is there a formula to solving life's problems? Well, maybe not a formula, but using some of these steps may help. Take responsibility for your problems. Okay. Sometimes unexpected things happen and cause big problems in your life. Yes, absolutely, life is unfair. It is such an inconvenience. In fact, you don't even deserve this. And you certainly don't have time to deal with some problems that arise. Right now, you just kind of want to crawl under a rock, hoping that your problem will go away. But what good will that do? It's not going to solve your problem. It's not good to blame others, complain, or make excuses. But what you can do is learn. Maybe life's trying to teach you something. Who knows? With this in mind, take responsibility and use the problem as a challenge to get better. Having taken full responsibility for your problem, you are now in the right frame of mind to begin to solve your problem. The best place to start is looking at things that maybe you've used in the past to solve your problems. What worked? What didn't work? Our past can certainly provide us with many valuable insights, clues. However, it's important that we keep in mind that whatever worked in the past may not necessarily work right now. Certainly use the lessons from the past on how to solve life's problems and trying to apply them to your current problem. However, stay vigilant and aware of other possibilities. Turn your problem into questions. Thinking about how to solve life's problems always begins with proper perspective. However, in order to gain proper perspective, you need to ask the right questions. This, of course, begins the moment you decide to turn your problem into a question and start restating it in various ways. This has advantages because asking a question brings along with it possibilities and answers. It encourages us to focus on solutions rather than getting lost within the intricacies of our problem. Asking one question, of course, brings to mind other possible questions. And with every question being asked, you gain deeper insight that can help you solve your problem. While you're trying to solve your problem, you may get stuck. You'll reach a point where you just run out of ideas or you don't quite know how to proceed. At this point, where you need to look for alternative perspectives that will help shift your view of the problem. Books, of course, can be a tremendous help. Here at the library, we have tons. Throughout history, people have been solving all sorts of problems. Learn to use their stories of struggles and triumphs on how to solve life's problems in your own life. Likewise, ask people in your own life for their input, ideas, or suggestions. Their unique life experience might help you see your problem in a more favorable light. If you're ever struggling to solve a life problem, it can be helpful to start thinking in pictures. Pictures can help you bring your thoughts to life on paper in front of your eyes. Once there, you can begin playing with your thoughts, exploring thoughts, and even imagining them on paper in a variety of ways. Doing so will help you assess your problem from a unique vantage point and perspective that may lead to incredible breakthroughs and ideas. You can, of course, do this by doodling, mind maps, metaphors, diagrams. Just tap into your inner child and allow your imagination to run wild. Ponder the problem. Sometimes the harder we try to solve life's problems, the less progress we seem to make. Even if you have ever reached that point, then it can be helpful to step back from trying so hard and instead spend time pondering over your problem in a variety of ways. To ponder over a problem requires putting yourself into a relaxed state of mind and just allowing your imagination to go to work. You can, of course, do this while lying in bed, walking along, while meditating. Sometimes it just takes time to solve the problem. You need to give your ideas the space to manifest, grow, and expand in your imagination. Those are steps you may take to solve life's problem. It's not quite a foolproof formula, but it is ideas and can certainly help working through life's problem far more effectively. Some problems will, of course, take a little more effort and time to solve. Just maybe you might not even be able to solve all of them. You might very well fail sometimes, but the idea is that you get back on your feet and you try and you try. But within every failure, there is a seed of opportunity to learn and grow from every experience that will help you solve your problems in better ways. Now, I hope you have enjoyed this Ways to Wellness. Thanks for watching.